It's a trailing electron wall facing multipurpose particle physics spectrometer in space. Particles and nuclei are defined by their charge and by their energy. So on top is a transition radiation detector, measure identified electron and positron, followed by this detector, this measure charge energy, and then nine layers of silicon detector, measure charge and moment. The magnet is used to distinguish the sign of the charge, positive in one way, negative in another. This is a detector, measure charge and energy. This is the detector, measure electron positron dump. And therefore, charge and energy or momentum are measured independently by many detectors. So, this is a view how the detector looks. The electron goes through this detector, will leave this place. The proton leave this place, the helium leave this type of place. It's just like hospital, you take an expert, except this happens in a billionth of a second. The magnet we use is a permanent magnet. We use first on MSO1, now on MSO2. This magnet is paid by the United States, was manufactured in the People's Republic of China. The main reason 95% of the best material for permanent magnet comes from Inner Mongolia, which I think is this moment part of China. Now, so the first detector made in Germany is for a visual counter. It's a very thin layer of counter. And the idea is very simple. Cosmic ray goes in all directions. So you may want to analyze the up and down. So the side one, you want to reject, but you have to do it very efficiently. And so the efficiency is 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9. I heard of efficiency. Excellent. And so this is the construction of this detector. They're made of scintillators with globes inside, so optical fiber can collect the light, so the light, the efficiency. Time of flight counter, measure the flight time from up to down to 152%. A major detector is called transition radiation detector. Mostly made in purpose of oversmart electron. You have a fleet or a piece of paper. You have a stack of paper. When an electron goes passes through the boundary of this paper, then you emit light. You have a tube, and inside the tube you fill with very dense xenon and CO2, and if you have a very thin gold wire and a high voltage on it, you will absorb this light ray, and you know that the electron will pass through. The electron is the only one who has this property. So the trick then is to produce this 2 meters long, thin, proportional counter. So right now there is a small tube detector manufacturer. After you manufacture, you do not know whether you center it or not. So at night, you go to a hospital. As it goes through a CT machine, and you choose the ones that center for 100 microns. And so out of 9,000, 5,000 tubes. This is a very large group of people. how you do it. The next attacker from also invading Italy, Switzerland, and Germany. It's a silicon detector. And it has a 10-meter pitch, provides the coordinate resolution of a particle to 10 microns. 10 microns means 1/10 the thickness of your hair. The constant precision you require. So, this detector. Light rays, this has been measured Kobe, by Hubble, by Indigo, by Fermi, over 50 years. We have all our knowledge up and down about space is from the measurement of light waves. All our understanding about cosmos is from the measurement of light waves. But in space, besides light waves, charged cosmic ray is a nearly unexplored region of time. The magnetic spectrometer on space station is the only way to provide long duration, 20 years, high precision measurement of charged cosmic rays. In other words, you don't need to know anything else about the physics. In space, there are two types of particles. So one centrifugal module is function of energy, function of nuclear charge, all the radiation cosmic resource. So the measure from 100 million electron volts to 2 trillion electron volts. So 1% accuracy over the entire solar cycle. This will be extremely important use when you send a man to this planet, because this radiation it will kill you. Another physics is the origin of dark. We know 90% of the matter in the universe is not observable. Because we don't see it, you probably find it. So this is the galaxy. If you can see that matter in the galaxy, in the cosmos, cosmic rays, the protons, electrons, cosmic rays collide with each other and produce positrons. How do you look for the origin of dark matter? You cannot see the dark matter, but collision of dark matter will produce additional positrons with a certain characteristic. These characteristics characteristic additional positron can be measured very accurately by it. And so it was for the first time attempt to understand where is the other 90%. Another physics of the math is to search for antimatter. The universe began with the Big Bang. Before the Big Bang, there was vacuum. Nothing existed. After the Big Bang, there must be equal amount of matter and antimatter. Otherwise, it would not have come from the vacuum. So AMS, on the space station for 20 years, was searching for the existence of antimatter to the age of the universe. This is why we do such a large detector for 20 years. Another thing is to search for new form of matter in the universe. And this is also done by Professor Jack Sandweiss, also a member of the National Academy. When you read the newspaper, you know, from the accelerator over the last 30 years, we found the smallest elements are called quarks. And there are six types of quarks as we find. But it's very strange. All matter on Earth is only made out of the first two, U and D. The question is anywhere in the universe, matter made at least three quarks, U, D, and S. And this can be found. If you think about it, there are six types of quarks that do not exist. Why on Earth, the only all the material made out of the first two are the material in the cosmos made out of at least three. This is a very simple.